in the IDE directly. It's a bit difficult here on the chair, but I hope it will work. Yes, we want to see something about PHP, using an IDE. This is just some information about me. Come from Germany, north of Hamburg, and we're mostly doing VirtualMart development, e-commerce development for Joomla. And yes, I've been on all German Joomla days, by the way. We have our next Joomla day in Germany in October. If you want to come or sponsor or whatever, you're welcome. Yes. Some shameless self-promotion. We're offering our service at vmexpert.com, vmexpert.com. We do mostly Joomla e-commerce. That's what we are specialized in. Yes, about this session, we want to see if it's really useful to use an IDE for Joomla development, what IDEs are available, how to set up a project, and these smaller things, tips, tools, debugging, and so on. And yes, I've prepared some slides. As I said, we want to step over into the IDE later. Before we start, this is what I show you is not the ultimate way how to use an IDE or how to do Joomla development. There are, of course, different ways and different approaches how to configure a project and so on. And as I already said on the website, I'm not affiliated or anything else with PHP Storm or JetBrains. It's just that I have tried nearly all available IDEs on the market, also the commercial IDEs, and I'm very happy with PHP Storm now. Yes, and PHP Storm is not open source, unfortunately, but they offer a free license for open source developers. If you can prove that you're an open source developer, then you can ask for a free license. I've tried it as I was team member in the VirtualMart team. I received a free license. Okay, then we can start. A lot of people still use an editor, which is not wrong. Most of the editors available have added a lot of features over the years, and they are nearly IDEs. But there are special features available in an IDE that makes it an IDE. Normally we have some kind of project management. We have support for content versioning and Git, SVN, and so on, and deployment systems with the servers. What often is missing that you have different deployment settings for testing, staging, and so on. This can be done with Git, for example, but it would be nice if this could be in the IDE directly, from my point of view. Yes, code parsing, framework support. We all work with Joomla. We all know that Joomla has a framework which is changing over the times, and so it's very helpful from my point of view if you have this auto completion, this framework support that helps you with the changes in the framework and shows you with functions are not supported anymore and so on. Yes, then we have, as a web developer, we have a combination of technologies. We mostly use PHP, but we also have to deal with HTML, JavaScript, CSS, and so on and so on. And so it's important that an IDE can supports all of these technologies and also the mixture of these technologies. PHP Storm has a great feature, which is this code injection that even recognizes when you have in an echo string, for example, in PHP, an HTML string. It recognizes that this string is HTML and helps you with the HTML then. Okay, and then this code parsing also displays errors in your code before you execute it. It mostly underlines it with a red line or so, and that also helps, of course. Development tools are the, for me, the most important part in the IDE. The debugger is, if you never have used the debugger and you start with it, you can't imagine how you live without it. And the profiler, refactoring, diff tools, and so on. There are a wide range of tools that, that can be used with an IDE. Of course, there Eclipse has big advantages there because of the plug-in system of Eclipse, where you can add different tools. And this is one of the advantages of Eclipse, for example. Yes, there are several good IDEs on the market. First, NetBeans, which is open source and free, which is also a full-featured IDE for PHP and also very good. I could not get so familiar with NetBeans, but that's my personal thing. Eclipse, PHP Eclipse, does exist very long, but yes, Eclipse is a great tool. It's extensible and it's free and so on, but it also needs a lot of yes, hardware power. It's sometimes very slow and so on. Yes, if I wouldn't use PHP Storm, I would use Eclipse, I think. Then the commercial one, Zen Studio. It's based on Eclipse. It's quite one of the most expensive, but it's also good. It also the biggest advantage of Zend is that they, of course, support all these Zend server tools and so on with what they also offer. Yes, PHP Storm, what we are talking about. And then I found a website where you where somebody has listed IDEs where open source developers can have free licenses. The link is down there. The presentation will be somewhere online after JEP, so you can see the, get the link there. Yes, this is quite good list. Also, PHP Storm is on the list, so there are all the different IDEs. One of the biggest disadvantages of an IDE is the learning curve. It's quite hard to get familiar with the IDE. There are such a lot of features, such a lot of keyboard shortcuts, combinations, whatever. It's you have to get familiar with it. You have to invest some work to get all these features usable for you. And some of the features require a special setup. For example, the biggest example, or the best example for that, is the debugging feature. When you look in forums for the IDEs, you always the most questions is, I cannot get Xdebug to run or whatever. So there are a combination of tools that have to work together, because the IDE uses PHP to parse the code, uses Xdebug, for example, for debugging and profiling and so on, and all these tools have to work together, and this has to fit your configuration, your setup, your project, and so on. And last but not least, maybe you have to change your workflow a bit, because an IDE has some kind of philosophy how good workflow should be. Most IDEs can be configured that it works like you want it, but some features may require that you have to think over your workflow. In PHP Storm, the strangest part when you start with it is how to save your files, because normally you open a file, you save a file, and so on. In PHP Storm, they have the philosophy that you always save the set of files, and when you close or when you can configure it, if you change the focus of the application, then it saves automatically. That's something you have to see if it works for you. But first it was strange, but now I'm so used to it that I always forget to save when I use another editor, for example. This is just the most important keyboard shortcuts of PHP Storm. So you can see that there are a lot of things to get familiar with, to get used to, and yes, to learn. But there are also tools that help you with finding these features. Of course, you have some hardware requirements with an IDE. It's like also with an editor. As a developer, you need a large monitor, of course. I have a 2 monitor set up with a notebook, and that helps a lot. Memory is important, of course, and it should be quite up-to-date computer that you're using. PHP Storm, for example, is not so difficult with the performance or with the hardware like Eclipse, but it also needs some. If you have a large project and you have the IDE has to pass all the code, it's some work for the computer. Yes, now we're starting with the Joomla part when it comes to using an IDE or PHP Storm. These are the 3 different ways how I personally set up projects. There may be, of course, more different ways, but these are the ways or these are the things we normally work with when we just create an extension or have to create a template or whatever. Then we just create the directory structure of the extension and add the Joomla libraries for the code completion and so on as external files. The second one, which is the most what we work with when we have a virtual expert projects, we download the non-standard Joomla, the non-standard directories and files from the server we have to work with, and add again the Joomla libraries as external files, so that we just have the things we have to check and work with and so on our local machine. And the third one is the whole site, where you have all the whole site on your local machine as a project, and which you can. So you can run it from your local web server, XAMPP or MEMP or whatever you're using. This is the setup which is best for debugging. You can make the other, or the number 2, you can also make it work for debugging, but that's quite difficult. Then it's faster to just download the project. yes, and then when you... Oh, this. I wanted to add some more, but I didn't know what I should add there, because it's just the extensions directory and what you're working on. This is how to include external files when you want to when you just have your extensions directory or the directories you work on. Then you can set up the libraries and includes files from Joomla, and then you have most of the code completion and the framework working in your IDE. So this is for the IDE. This is a full Joomla then. yes. What I just said. This is what we normally use. This where we download most of the non-standard Joomla project stuff. Yes, full site. we had one project directory where we had all of this stuff in it. I found out that it's a bit better to put to create another level in the directories. So you have the site one level below the project directory, because when you have this full directory with debugging, with profiling, and so on, you can put all this stuff nicely in your project directory, and you don't have to add this to your Joomla root. And here we already see that all these thing scripts are used for packing our extensions and so on. are located there. Normally there would be a profiler directory where the profiling log files are stored. And yes, this is my and this is my web root then when in my XAMPP file, the source directory. Any questions about that, how to structure the directory structure, or how to store the project files on the local machine? You have to keep in mind that PHP Storm always, or the IDE always scans the whole tree, so the larger the tree is, directory tree is, of course, the longer it takes to create this or to run this parsing process. Yes, as I said, the debugger is one of the most important tools in the IDE, and you have to get it to work. Of course, you need a local server. You need Xdebug running on your local server, and PHP and the IDE. There are different settings, different problems in the settings. You have to set up Xdebug in your PHP INI and have to make it communicate with your IDE so that it works. And there are some may occur some problems, but normally I have the PHP INI settings from my local MAMP XAMPP. I can show you that on the IDE. And yes. And yes, other than, for example, Visual Studio, this is not all integrated. This has to use all these different technologies where you have to tell how to communicate. So when the debugger works, you have a lot of tools you can use in the debugger. This is a standard debugging screen. When you load the web page in the browser, you can set a breakpoint where you want to stop the IDE, or where you want to stop the process of loading the website. And you can also have conditional breakpoints. You can say, okay, if this variable has this value, then this breakpoint should fire. And if not, then just skip this breakpoint. And when the code when you load the website and the code reaches this breakpoint, the PHP Storm or the IDE screen comes to front and shows you this screen. And there you have different options. This is the window where you see all the variables that are loaded, all the objects. You can drill down in the objects and so on, and see the values. And you can also define watches, also conditional watches and so on, where you have special variables you want to watch. And here's the navigation where you can say, okay, I want to step over this call, or I want to step in and want to see what's going on, what the functions and what all the code that lies under this call does. So you can really go through the code step by step and line by line and function by function. So it's very, very easy. Or yes, it's big help to find problems or errors in your code. Of course, you can have several breakpoints, so you can jump from one breakpoint to another. And this is yes, as I said, very helpful in the debugging process. yes, when you start the debugging, you have to, here's a small telephone listener icon, you have to tell the IDE that it should start listening for Ixtibug on the configured port, and then the IDE will do this and show you that. Sometimes, for example, when you use the index PHP for a breakpoint, sometimes the IDE may ask you for the right mapping on your server, because it may find different index PHP files. So you just have to select the correct index PHP, and to make the mapping correct then. as I said, I want to show this on the live IDE. That's the slides are not so good to show how it really works, so I just put some slides together to just show you the most important tools. The profiler, unfortunately a lot of people or a lot of developers don't use a profiler. In PHP Storm, the profiling support is available since the newest version, since version 3, I think. Now it's version 4. The profiling data is also made or comes from Ixtibug. You can configure the profiler in there. And the profiler then writes a large file, a very large file, where all function calls, all PHP calls, all everything your code does is listed. And PHP Storm, or there are other tools, for example, Web Cache Grind, also, which is nearly the same as the tool in PHP Storm. Can read this file and show you what functions and what code is very time consuming, which code is called very often, and so on. So you have some nice tips where you can start to make your code faster. When you have a function which is called in a loop, and you have see that there are 500 calls of this function, and you see that it's consuming a lot of seconds, then it would be a good idea to start there and check, is it really needed that you have to call this function in the loop, or can you call the function before the loop and create an array which you use in the loop, or whatever. There are different ways to optimize that, but it's very, very helpful to really see what the code is doing, where the time is spent, how often different functions are called, and it's very helpful to make your code faster. And the good thing when this is supported by the IDE is that you can just double-click on the lines here in the profiler. There are different views in the profiler. You can always drill down, and you can just click on the code, and it jumps directly to the source where this code is located, and where this 99 seconds or milliseconds are consumed, and so on. So you can directly jump there and see what's going on there. And yes, I personally think it's very helpful at the not at the end, but when I'm at 75%, for example, of my extension development, then I start using the profiler just to see what's where are slow parts, and so that I can use some time to optimize that. Yes, for the debugger and the profiler, there are some browser add-ons available for Firefox and Chrome that are quite helpful. For Chrome, you just have to need to search for Ixtibug in the Firefox add-ons directory and the Chrome store, and it's quite helpful because you just click in the browser, debug the next page load or profile the next page load, and then it's active, and then it starts. You don't have to do strange things to start that. If you don't want to use these extensions, you can also use the small bookmarklets. I've got my own bookmark in the toolbar where I have different settings where you can use these bookmarklets to start debugging and stop debugging and start profiling and so on. That helps. It makes it just more comfortable. You're just testing your site on your local machine, and you say, something goes wrong. Start the debugger, reload, and you have you have the debugging process then. This is special for PHP Storm, but this is a really great thing. I think everybody knows Firebug. When you change something in Firebug on your browser, you can see it live on the output. But normally you have to keep it in mind and change it in the editor afterwards. CSS Xfire is a plugin for PHP Storm which does that for you. It records all the changes you're doing in Firebug and shows you in PHP Storm all the changes you've made. As a drill down option where you can apply all changes, or you apply just selected changes, and this is really great when you're developing a website, or when you're doing templating or virtual mod templates or whatever. Then you play around in the browser, and you go back to PHP Storm, and you have all the stuff there, and also recognize when you're changing CSS elements 3 or 4 times. It only takes, of course, the last change then. And it's such an helpful tool. I always use it like this when I have to do things on the website layout. And that also works in Chrome, but not so very good when you have Firebug Lite in Chrome. It also works, but in Firefox it's much better with Firebug. Code Sniffer. This is a new feature in PHP Storm, which is available in Eclipse for a longer time, of course. But this is sometimes annoying, but sometimes very helpful. This feature helps you to keep your code cleaner and sticking to coding standards. Joomla, for example, in the wiki offers a download of the Joomla coding styles. This can be imported not imported, but made available for the Code Sniffer. PHP Code Sniffer is also an external tool which has to be configured in your local environment, but if it's there, PHP Storm recognizes that, and you can just select your Joomla coding style, and then PHP Storm helps you to keep the style. I have just a very simple example here. This is just how PHP Storm shows you that this is not after the coding styles, and when you move your mouse over it, it tells you what you should do better or change. There's a gray underlining here, and this is also when you have if clauses or brackets on the same line and so on. All these things are parsed and showed in your editor, and it helps. As I said, sometimes it's really annoying because you say, why should I do that? I always do it different. But when you get used to it, it makes it's really good because it makes your code look better. And when you offer something to the Joomla project, for example, they expect from you that you're using this coding standards. Otherwise, your submission will be rejected. And yes, as I said, when you change it here, the gray line is gone, and everything looks good. The Code Sniffer works with the in inspections in PHP Storm. There are a lot of inspections. You can activate, deactivate them just as you need it in your personal settings or the way you work. These inspections are very helpful. They always show you errors or sometimes auch sometimes logical errors. For example, one inspection is when you have in an if clause just one equal sign. This is sometimes it's you want it like this because you want to assign the value in the variable to the variable directly in the if clause, but often it's a logical error, yes, which doesn't produce a PHP error, but it will never return a false in the if clause because it's always true. And this can be underlined, for example, by the inspections and help you to avoid these errors. But the inspections are, of course, time-consuming on your machine because everything you have to activate it in the inspections has to be checked, and this may eat performance. And so you should take some time to check if the inspections are the way you need them. Yes, there are a lot of small tools and small tricks and so on in the IDEs you can use that make the work easier. It's a wide range. As I prepared the script, the slides, I just didn't know where to start and where to end. So I just put the most important I always use in here. This is, as I know, rarely unknown by most of the PHP Storm users. You can use scopes in your projects, and this is quite helpful when you have these large projects like Joomla projects with all of the directories, all files, and so on. It's a long list of directories. And it's quite helpful if you have, like me, a naming system of your extensions. Our extensions always start with VMX, and so it's very easy to create this pattern. So when you add this pattern to your scope, this is what the project looks like. And when you change this to the scope VM extensions, then you just see the list of your extensions, and directly in the root you see the direct path to the component directory. For example, this saves a lot of time when you're clicking through the directories and so on, and this is very helpful because you just see your own stuff in the project, even if you have the whole Joomla website in your project tree. This is also something I always use. Eclipse and I think NetBeans 2 and PHP Storm, they all have a to-do feature where you can add some information to your code, some comments where you have to. Yes, something to do, but I also use this for different kinds of notes and notifications and so on. And you can configure this. You can configure different kinds of icons there and so on. And the good thing is when you have a project which you have worked 3 or 4 months ago, and you really don't remember what things you have changed there. I can just look up my to-do list and see all the files, all the lines of code I have changed. And also this is always the same. You just double-click on this entry and it jumps directly to the code. And this is really helpful. You just have to get used to it once that you always do it. And when you always do it, it's very, very helpful that you can rely on this list to see what changes you have done. Most of the IDEs allow to add external tools to your IDE. This is very helpful. I use this a lot. I have a number, I don't know, about 20 or 25 small PHP scripts I use for different things. This is one I've made a checkpoint, so I can right click on it's not on the screenshot here. I can right click on any directory in my project tree, and then I have this menu, and I can say make checkpoint, and this script I've written as the external tool just makes a zip of all the files in this directory and below this directory. I'm quite paranoid to lose changes and so on. Then I do this to just put away a zip before I make a lot of strange changes also. And the good thing is that you have that you can configure the external tools. You have a lot of variables from the IDE you can use, like directories, project names, whatever, file name, line number. It all depends on in which area you want to use this external tool. So you can add all these things in the parameters for the tool you want to call, and then you can use that. And yes, I like it very much. I use this a lot because it's, you just add it once and then you can use it anytime. You can also call, of course, it doesn't have to be a PHP script what you call, but you can also call external FTP scripts or whatever, what to upload or whatever. You can call any program on your system to use it with these external tools. Yes, there are sometimes it may happen that you don't have code completion in your code. I don't know why. I think it happens when there are when the object is handed over in several references, that sometimes PHP Storm loses this the connection to the original object. I don't know, but it's not very often, but sometimes it happens that you don't have a code completion. For example, here the cursor is here, nothing opens, nothing happens. Then you can have add a PHP doc comment. You don't have to use the menu, you can do it on your own, but also here, when PHP Storm thinks that you need some help, then there is this small light bulb here with some additional functions, and you add a PHP doc comment, so you can say, okay, my model is VMX, my model name, and then PHP Storm knows that this model belongs to this object, and then it shows all the functions or methods in the object. That's quite helpful when you sometimes miss the code completion. Questions up to now. Now I would want to switch to the real editor, so that we can see how things look in the real IDE. Some questions up to here, or other suggestions? What I do too complicated or whatever you're using? No. Okay, then I have to sit down. And I hope the problem is that, oops, okay. as I said, I'm quite paranoid. I have a lot of tools that save my current work. I have every 15 minutes, my whole PHP Storm project directory is scanned for changes and synchronizes this to a cloud server and to an external hard drive. And even though PHP Storm offers offers an internal change log where you can see the changes and you can just restore them, but it's quite helpful for me I like it when I have a large directory with zip files every 15 minutes where I can go back to see what I've done. Because we just talked about it, this is the local change log. Okay, this is a Joomla index PHP where nothing really happened. And I just open another directory where a bit more. This is, as I said, the IDE. It's a bit difficult with this resolution to show and use everything. There are different windows and flyouts and everything that you can use on the screen, and you can see I'm using here the scope I just showed you, and so I have direct access to the component directory and so on. And when I now open this once again, why do I have changes? Then you see all the changes I've done, and you see, like in a normal div tool, what I've changed here. And this is very helpful when you're in the working process. You also see the other actions. I've uploaded this version to the live server and so on. So this is very helpful when you want to. When you're in the working progress. Yes. When we go to the configuration screen, you have a lot of things that you can configure in an IDE. This is similar to other IDEs where you have all the different settings. You have on the one hand side, you have the project settings that apply to the open project, and the IDE settings that are the more basic settings. Important, for example, is when you want to use this. On your deploying the data or the code to a server, then you can configure here your different servers and so on, and of course your FTP, SFTP, whatever data, and then the mappings, what you have on your local machine and where it should go on the live server. And here you can exclude directories or paths on your machine so that they are not deployed. Then you have different options. There are this one is the most important on this page. This is when you save something on your local machine, then it's automatically uploaded. You should think about if you should do this on a live site. This is helpful, of course, on a test server when you change something, save something, and then it's automatically on the server. And this is working quite good. So you just have to configure your server, and then you have to have all the synchronization on when you save. This is what I just showed you, the include, or when you include the external Joomla files. And yes, and oops, when we now want to debug something, then we have all this mapping done and so on. So we told the IDE where the files in the web root are located in the project, then we can in Chrome I have 50 tabs open, so because that would take a little longer. And where is it? I could have done that before. Just a second. What's new? I don't know why the patch is running. Normally should. Okay, offline modus. Okay, no, it's running. It took some time, and as I said, there are these tools where you can start the debugging process. And as I showed you, I've added a breakpoint here. I switch on the listener in PHP Storm, and now I just reload the page. And then, as I said, PHP Storm sees when the point or xdebug tells PHP Storm when the point is reached, where you are in the page loading process. And now I can go down through all the objects you may know from your development, and you can see everything what is done here, and you can also change them. Why not? So okay, set value. You can also change the values. You can during the side load, you can change the values when the side loads. So you can test different things or can correct things and see if it works correctly then. And when you now go through the code and it jumps to the code that is okay, to the code that is called at the place of your breakpoint, and then you can say okay, that looks good. You can step out and go on with the normal code and then complete the site. Okay, just enter. And then the page is loaded, and the same for the profiler. When you load the page with the profiler enabled, so when I now reload the page, it should take a little longer because it didn't take longer. Because it has to write all the things in the profiling directory, and then you webroot. Where's my webroot? There it is. Dev profiler, and then you see the. The whole list of functions and classes that are called and during the side load. It's a bit difficult because, as I said, the screen is too small. You can sort it then, and you can when you know your code, you might see where you have to step into, and then you see all the different. Places where is where the code is called, and it goes down and down and down, and at some place there is then you can jump to the original code. Just a second. Close it once again. You have to run the profiler in the browser, and then you have tools. Analyze Xdebug profiler snapshot, and then you have to select the file that you have configured in Xdebug, where the log file is located. This is a very large file, even on small pages. This is a very, very large file that can easily become 2, 3, 4 or more megabyte, this file. So it is a bit of work to parse this file, and then it helps you to show the different time consuming functions. Yes. What else is interesting? More the settings or more the tools we could use? When we just go through the different menus, you have, as I said, a lot of things that you can do and configure in your IDE. A quite helpful key shortcut in PHP Storm is Command Shift A. On Windows, I think it's Control Shift A, where you can just start typing when you know that there is a function that you don't find. You just type the name you want to search, and all the features are shown and reformat code, and it also shows you the keyboard shortcut there, and that's very helpful. By the way, this reformat code function or feature is very helpful too, because it recognizes the coding standards that you've added. So you just can, for example, add or just mark this. Just a second. Command A. And you can select if you want just the selected code, and then it reformats it. Just make the same example here again. And when I just do it, then the spaces are back there. So it reformats it. What it doesn't do. It doesn't convert the indention, unfortunately, because Joomla wants tabs in the indention and no spaces. But you can do this also here. So toggle and now why is it still? Ah, now they're gone. As you see, the inspection takes some seconds to see this. So now, as I said, the gray lines are gone, and everything, should be like the Joomla coding standard. There are also a lot of things. As I said, sometimes it's annoying when you, for example, have a comment which starts with a small letter. then it says a comment should start with a capital letter. Okay, it's just these are they're very helpful, but sometimes also annoying. We only have two or three minutes. Are there any questions?
Yep. Yeah. Und zwar, wie kriege ich das hier bei JDoc, dass er mir das nicht als Fehler anzeigt?
You have to that you don't have. Yeah, I just wanted to. The question was how to configure that JDoc in the templates is not shown as an error.
I include libraries module.
Yeah, but JDoc, this is not a PHP tag or whatever. You have to set it up in the inspections. I can show you that. but this is in the inspections. All of the underlining, all of the errors, all of the stuff you see in the editor is done by the inspections. You can disable them. You can create your own inspections and so on, so that you have a clean editor view. And by the way, it's not seen here. There is always on the right hand side of the editor, you can see this list. These are warnings and also errors. Too many code sniffer messages. Okay, and this is quite helpful. Also in the project tree, you see when there are files with errors.
Hmm? So.
Yes, of course. Yes, you can. There are a wide range of file types supported. Okay, JavaScript also CSS.
In Firework, when you edit in Firework, you have the.
Yes. Yes, exactly. I can. I have to stop now. But anyone, I'm here all the days. If we want to go through things, I always want to learn things too. We can sit together and try some things. It is safe to CSS files. What doesn't work in this Firebug thing is that it saves to ZAS or LESS files. Unfortunately, because I often use. No. The Firebug thing is always for CSS. It's only for CSS.
Only CSS.
Yes. Yes, that's right. Yeah. Okay. As I said, you can ask me anytime, anything. We can get together. I always want to learn something new. I hope it was a bit helpful. It was a bit difficult here on the setup, but I hope it was interesting for you. Thank you.